Hi, welcome back to a new workout. Today we're going to do a standing Pilates workout. You don't need any equipment. All exercises are standing, of course. So get ready and let's start. Okay, here we go. We're starting this workout with a short warm-up. 5 exercises to warm up the body a little bit, and then we go over to the main workout. Main workout today is 10 different exercises, all standing. No rest in between the exercise. We go from one to the other, and after the 10 exercises, we have a break, then repeating the round, and we finish with a bit of stretching at the end. So first of all, warm up, and we start with the head roll. So pull the shoulders down, feet on hip wide, and knees are slightly bent, and then bring that head towards your chest. Left ear to your left shoulder, then roll your head back over to your right side and back to your chest, and then over from right to left. Just a couple of rolls. Left to right, right to left. Bring your ears as close to your shoulders if you can. Roll. And we do one more to the other side, roll, and bring your head up. Now over to the shoulders, making big shoulder rolls. Pull the shoulder blades together, press the shoulders down, and then touch each other to the front, opening up. Big ones, that's it. Rotate your shoulders. Because in the main workout, we're going to use the arms, so have to make sure the shoulders are loose and warm. Reverse those rolls, so opening your chest, bringing the shoulders up to the ears, open up, that's it. Big ones, roll up, big shoulder rolls towards the ears, lifting up, two more. And the last one. And from the shoulder rolls, we're going to do arm circles. And I have to go a little bit more to the side. So circle those arms from the back to the front. Really opening up, make them as big as you can. Roll up, and that's it. Pull your belly in, your back straight, your knees still slightly bent. And make the big circles. And from the back to the front, we're going to reverse in 3, 2, 1. And now from the front side, up to the back, and still make them big. Big circles, opening up, rotate, shoulder blades together. That's it, keep your upper body straight up, lift up your chest and make big arm circles. And 3 more, 2, and the last one. That's it. Okay, now from the upper body, we're going to the lower body, opening the hips, pulling the knees up, pull the knee to the outside, and walk back. So pull that knee up to the outside. And while we do that, we keep the hips still and the upper body up straight. Knee up, opening up, walk back. And do that slow. So pull that knee to the side as far as you can and then lowering down. Hip mobility, that's it. Just a few more and then we do one final exercise and then we're ready to go over to the main exercises. Like I said, no rest in between the exercises. Just going from the first to the second and so on. So lift that knee up, open to the outside. One more on each side, finish on that right side, and that's it. And now, come into a little wide stand, knees slightly bent, and we're going to do full body rolls. So we press the hips and rotate the upper body as well. So press the hips out to the front, back, and rotate the upper body as well. Circling up, releasing all the tension out of the body. So we're good to go over to the main workout and reverse those circles. Full body circles, upper body, lower body, everyone circle around. And the last one, that's it. Okay, now come on up, shake out. And now we're going over to the main exercises, 10 different ones. The first one is in a wide stand, knees are slightly bent, tuck that belly in, upper body straight up. That's the posture you want to have with every exercise. So knees slightly bent, press the knees out, tuck the belly in, engage your abs, upper body straight up. And what we're going to do in the first exercise is just reaching from side to side with that upper body as far as we can. So we reach over to left, reach over to left and right. Switching from side to side. So that weight is going on the left side and you reach over as far as you can. Keep your chest open, so do not twist in, keep it open. And reach from side to side, side to side. That's it. Lift up your chest, shoulders down low. Make yourself long and reach out. Pulsing from side to side. That's it. Press your feet into the floor while pulsing over to the right side and back left. 20 seconds. And then we go over to the next exercise. We're going to lift the knee up, finding our balance, and circle the arms up and down while tapping the knees. Just follow me along. We're going to do the exercises again in that second round so you know the moves then. Final reach on left, and lower those arms down. So the next one, arms is going up. We tap the knee and circle those arms up. And when you lift that knee up, just hold it a second in front. Don't lock that standing leg. Keep your upper body straight up and find that balance. Pilates is not about a fast pace. Working with your body. Tuck that belly in. Lift that knee up, working the lower abs. Engage it and then lowering down. That's it. Tap your knee and bring up. Keep your upper body straight up, your shoulders straight above the hips. Standing legs slightly bent, and we have 15 seconds left. Then we're going to do windmill bends. So come on, lift up, hold a second, and tap. One more on left, and we finish on that right side. That's it. Come into a wide stand again. Knees slightly bent, arms out, and now stretch your leg. Just keep it slightly bent. And then tap your toe, coming up. Tap your toe, coming up. We stay on one side for about 30 seconds and then we switch. So keep the arms up, shoulders low, chest up. Bend and tap. Bend and tap. And we do one more on that right side and then going over to the left. Hop. Bring your hands back up, upper body in center, and then bend. Try to touch your toes. If you can't touch your toes, of course, bend as far to that side as you can. Working your waistline up. Just a few more. And then we're going to do side leg pulses and lifts for the outer thighs. And that's it. Coming up, lower your arms down. Hands in your waist, knees slightly bent. We started on left. We pulse. Lift up three times and then pulse. Two, three. Lift, two, three, and then pulse. Two, three. And while you lift that leg up, it's important you don't move your upper body. Just keep that upper body straight up and work it from your outer thigh. Over to the other side, find your balance. One, two, three, and pulse it. Without tapping the floor, finding that balance. One, two, three, and pulse it. One, two, three. That's it. Come on, almost there. Two, three, and pulse it. We can do one more. One, two, three, and pulse. Keep that upper body still. And that's it. Okay, back to the upper body. We're going to open up. Reverse pulse is what we're going to do. One, two, three, and then lower it down. One, two, three. One, two, three. Up and down. Palms forward, palms back. And really open your chest, bringing the shoulder blades together, working the backside of your shoulders and the upper part of your back up. And again, tuck that belly in, no hollow back, tuck it in, knees slightly bent, don't forget about it. Open up and reverse. Up and down. Just a few more, come on. Bring the shoulder blades together as far as you can, toning that upper part of the body. Open up, and that's it. Okay, the next one is, almost forgot about it, deadlift with the curl and come on up. We do about 30 seconds on one side. So bend over as far as you can. Your standing leg is slightly bent, and then when you're up, you curl that rear leg, heel is towards your butt. That's it. So bend over, curl, and come on up. That's it. Up, and one more on this side, and then switching over to the other side. Find that balance and curl. Come on up. So your standing leg is slightly bent. Focus on your balance, lift that leg up, curl, and come on up. That's it. Up. And just a few more. Up. Final one. Bend over, curl, and come on up. Okay, the next one is a side step and our inner thigh lift. So we step to the side, a little pulse, and then bring that leg to the inside, lifting that heel up, working the inner thigh. Up. And you don't have to go deep, just a slight bend. Push yourself up and then bring that inner thigh up, lifting that leg up. And we do one more on this side. And now switching over to the other side, stepping out and lift that leg up. In front of you, cross it over, work the inner thigh while keeping that upper body straight up. That's it. Up and lift. Working your glutes, your inner thighs. Not too deep, just a slight bend, that's it. Lift up one more. And now we're going over to the upper body again. Feet on hip wide, knees slightly bent, upper body straight up. Hands in front. What we're going to do is we curl, hands towards the ears, and then opening up, bringing the shoulder blades together, open up as far as you can. Then close, extend, curl, open, extend. So you keep your elbows up at all times, opening up, and make sure you tuck that belly in, engage your core, up. So you bring your hands to your ears, opening up, squeeze the shoulder blades together, open up as far as you can, then bring the elbows together and extend. That's it. Almost there. Up. Open up. And the final ones. Elbows are still. We do one more. Curl, open up, and extend. Lower the arms down. Okay, the next one is a wide stand. Press the knees out just a little bit. You don't have to go all the way deep. Just a little bit. Arms are going up, and we twist in, tapping the inside of the knees. And when you twist, you press the knees out, working the outer thighs up. Twist that upper body up. Press the knees out and twist. Tap the inside of your knees and bring your hands back up on shoulder height after that tap. That's it. And again, tuck that belly in, so do not pull your butt down. Pull it under, tuck it in, and then twist over. That's it. You're doing great, and we just have to do one more exercise after this, and then we finish the first round already. Twist it in, tap the knees, up, and the last one on left, and we finish on the right side, and coming up. Feet are on hip wide for the final exercise. We're going to swing down just a little bit, squeezing the glutes, heels into the floor, and then we reach out, come on high on the toes, finding that balance. Swinging down again, and come up. Down, Squeeze the glutes, engage your abs, find that balance when you're high on your toe, and then down, up, and down. Press the butt down, heels into the floor, and then come on up, reach out, find that balance, hold it, yes. Come on, 20 seconds left, and then we're done in that first round. So come on up, bend, press the heels into the floor, into that squat move, down, not too deep, high up your toes. Come on, we can do one more. So swing back, and come on up, find that balance, and that's it. Very well done. You finished the first round, now drink some water, just recover a little bit, and then I'll see you in the next round. Do the same 10 exercises, and we finish with a bit of stretching. Okay, here we go for round number two. The same 10 exercises, no rest in between those exercises. We go from the start till the end without any rest. We start into that wide stand again. Knees slightly bent, upper body straight up. Tuck that belly in, engage your abs, arms out, and we reach and pulse from side to side. So make sure your knee is not going over your toes, just stick above your toes, and then reach with that upper body. That's it. Reach. Press the knees out and reach. That's it. Come on, make yourself long, lift the chest up and reach over from right to left. Tuck your belly in, upper body straight up, shoulders above the hips, only bending from side to side. Keep your arms up and reach. 15 seconds. Then we're going to do the knee uplift with the arm circles. Up from left, come on, reach to right, left. One more, and lower down. So hands up, knees up, feet on hip wide, tap the knee up, and circle the arms back up. When you lift the knee, just hold it a second, find your balance, don't lock that standing leg, then come back up again. That's it. Find your balance, feel that power in your lower ab. Oh, arms down, arms up. Upper body is straight up. Bring that knee up, tap it, hold a second, find your balance. That's it. You can do it. Focus on one point in front of you, it's hard to find your balance. Lift up and hold a second. 15 seconds left, then we're going over to the windmill bends. Half a minute on one side and then half a minute to the other side. Lifting up, engage your abs, final one. And come into that wide stand, knees are slightly bent. And then bend and tap your toes. And of course, if you can't bend that far, just tap your chins or your knee. Just bend as far over as you can. Up. Just a few more on that right side. Bend over, tap your toes, come on all the way up. One more, and up over to that left side. Tap your toes, come on up. Upper body is straight up, arms out on shoulder height, only lowering that arm down to tap your toes. Up. Down, 15 seconds left. And then we go to that side leg lift with the pulses. Again, 30 seconds on one side and then we switch. So keep bending. Few more. Tap your toes. Final one. And come on up. Feet on hip wide. Shoulders down low and tap it. Two. Three. And then pulse. Without touching the floor, that's it. Three taps. And then hold it up and pulse it. Three. Knees slightly bent on that standing leg and upper body is straight up. Final one on left. One, two, three, and that's it. Over to the other side, tap it. Two, three, working the outer thighs, hem pulls. And one, two, three, and pulse it. Come on, 15 seconds left. Keep your upper body straight up. Tuck that belly in, engage your abs. Three, and pulse it. Feel that burn. Come on, tap it. Two, three, and we can do that pulse on this side. That's it. Okay, the next one is for the upper body. We're going to do the reverse arm opener. So come on, open up, two, three, and down. Make sure you tuck that belly in, engage your abs again, upper body straight up. And when you're opening up, make sure you squeeze the shoulder blades together as much as you can. Working the back of your shoulders and the upper part of your back. Up, palms front, and palms to the back. That's it. Come on, power. Opening up and pulse it. That's it. Three times up. And three times down. Up. And after this one, we go to the single deadlifts with that curl. And pulse it down, two, three. That's it. Okay. Knees slightly bent. Bend over and curl. Come on up. All the way up. Then bending over. Make that curl. And come on up. Find your balance. Bend over and curl. That's it. Your standing leg is slightly bent. Come on up. Bend over. And we can do one more on this side. And now we switch over. Finding the balance again. Now on your left leg, curl and come on up. So you first lift that leg up, and then when it's up, you make that curl. Working your hamstrings and, of course, your balance. So keep tucking that belly in, your back straight. Always engage your core. Up. Just a few more. Up. And then we're going to do that side step with the inner thigh lift. So step it out and lift up. Step it out, lift up. And try to lift that leg up as high as you can. Really work that inner thigh. And you don't have to do a deep lunge, just a little bit. Working the quad, the glute. Press yourself up. That's it. Almost there. Now we switch over, doing that same on the other side, right? Now, so switching over, stepping out, and lift up. Find that balance. Up, hold it, and slowly back. That's it. Upper body straight up. Pulse it out and lift that leg up. In. Almost there. And then we go to the bicep curls and the openers. One more. That's it. Okay, feet on hip wide. Arms up, so curl towards your ears, opening up all the way as far as you can. Bring the elbows close and then extend. That's it. Tuck your belly in, make sure your back is straight, knees are slightly bent. Always engage your ribs. And then curl, keep your elbows up. Opening up, shoulder blades together, and then close. That's it. Up. Zoning your arms, your shoulders, up. Open up as far as you can. That's it. Really push it. 15 seconds left. And then we go to that wide stand with an upper body twist, stepping the knees on the inside. Open up. Come on, open up. Bring those elbows out as far as you can and lower down into that wide stand. Arms up, press the knees out, and then twisting that upper body in, tapping the inside of your knee. So bend over a little bit so you can tap the knees. Try to keep your hips still, really opening up those hips. That's it. Twist that upper body, tap the knees, We're almost at the end. Just one more exercise after this. We finish with that balance swing on the heel raises. Come on, halfway. Just bend the knees a little bit. Tap it to the inside. Press the knees out. Keep the hips open. Arms up, don't lowering down. Tuck that belly in. 15 seconds left. Go from side to side. Left and right. Up. Final ones. Left and finish on right. Coming up, that's it. Final one, feet on hip wide. Press the heels down. When pressing that butt down, squeeze it. Come up on your toes, find that balance, and then lower it down again. It's the final one. So focus on that balance. Squeeze and lowering down. Come on high on your toes, find that balance. Pull that belly in. That's it. Just focus on your moves, pressing the heels down, squeeze your glutes, and coming up. Find that balance, hold a second, and then lowering down. So come on your toes, 20 seconds left. Up, press the heels down, squeeze the glutes, and coming up. Just a few more. Up, lowering down. Coming up, and we can do one more. So go down into that squat, and then hold it up. Hold it, hold it, hold it, and that's it. Very well done. That's it for the main workout. Now we're going to do some stretches. But first, just feet are a little bit wider than the knees. Then the hips and the knees are slightly bent. Then cross your arms, just swing. And of course, don't hollow your back, tuck it in. Active posture all the way. Swing your arms, releasing the tension because we had to hold those arms up for a lot of time. So swing it, releasing the tension. And after the swings, we're going to stretch the shoulders. So when you're ready, one arm is going in front of your chest, the shoulder is down low, and pull that arm towards your chest. You can feel that stretch in your shoulder all the way through. Just hold it a few seconds. Now you're going to do some swings and over to the other side, same stretch. Just enjoy that stretch in your shoulder. That's it, release, make a few swings. Releasing the tension, open your chest. And now, right arm is in front, shoulder down low, and pull that arm towards your chest. Feel that stretch in your shoulder. Pull it down, push it down, and pull to your chest. Just feel that stretch. And then, when you're ready, opening up again, make a few swings, cross it, and come into a wider stance. What we're going to do is we're going to push pulse through. So we bend over, and the hands are going between our legs, and just pull and swing. Your knees are slightly bent, and just try to reach farther every time you swing. So bend that upper body, bring the chest towards your knees, and swing. Just come up a little bit, releasing the tension while stretching the hamstrings a little bit. That's it. Just a few more swings. And from the straight swings, we're going to swing from side to side. So stay into that wide stand. Swing over from left to right. Releasing the tension out of your lower back. And we're stretching the hamstrings and the thighs a little bit by staying in that wide stand. Okay, come center. Bend the knees a little bit more. Rolling up. That's it. Shoulder rolls. And then we go back into that wide stand. We stay in that wide stand. And then if you can, place your hands on the floor. And we're going to pulse from left to right. Wider stand. If you can't feel that stretch on your inner thighs, just make a wider stand and pulse it from left to right. And of course, if you can't reach the floor, just stay up and do that side to side when you're up. Just choose your option. Bend it, Press your butt down, knees to the outside, stretching up the hips, the inner thighs. Just a few more. And now come center, walking your feet together. Close it up. Try to stick your hands on the floor. If you can't, just come up a little bit, but fold over, bringing your chest towards your knees, feeling that stretch. And then bend the knees, roll up. We're going to do one final release exercise, and that's for the ankle. So lifting the leg up and rotating your feet, releasing the tension out of your ankles. Don't lock that standing leg. Keep it slightly bent, upper body straight up. Reverse that circle, that rotation to the other side. And we're going to do that same rotation on the other side. So now standing on your left leg, knee slightly bent, and rotate your ankle. That's it. And reverse to the other side. That's it. And just shake it out. Swing it out. And that's it. Very well done. You finished this standing Pilates exercises, so this workout. So give yourself that well-deserved thumbs up. I hope you enjoyed this workout. Leave a comment, let me know what you think of this workout. If you have any requests for upcoming workouts, of course, let me know and I will see what I can do for you. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and have a great day.